In 40 years ago, 30, 40 years ago, it was the time that a lot of Asia country have the problem of eviction. Yeah, so the poor people have faced insecurity and faced the eviction. So once we met, there was one meeting in which we intend to share the experience and what shall we do to help each other and so on. So the problem of eviction happened in so many countries. It's quite serious, especially in Korea at the time before the Olympic game. They host the Olympic, and to host the Olympic properly, they make a lot of redevelopment. And redevelopment mean wherever poor or existing communities stay, they want to remodel, they want to redevelop, and the redevelopment mean the people who don't have proper right will get evicted, and they have done it in a big way, the whole city, right? So with the support from many friends, we think that we should set up, get together to be a coalition and see how we can help Korea. And then we send a team, a fact-finding team, to Korea before the Olympic game, yeah. So, you know, a very interesting team, a team that we try to select who should be interesting for the Korea government to listen. So we have one Buddhist monk, we have one Supreme Judge of India, you have the chairperson of the Habitat International Coalition, you have the MP from England. You sort of put different collectors together, and I was the secretary, yeah, organizing that. And then we went there to Korea, and we went to so many communities who faced the eviction. We talked to the government, we talked to the cardinal, we talked to the press, we talked to so many people, and make a very good report and send around throughout the world, right? And it's a good impact in some way. And shortly after that, the government announced the first time in history the public housing policy, yeah, which is a huge one. Of course, there are many other elements that make them go in that way, but we were one of them that contribute to this change. That's why we build the Asia Coalition from the problems and from the strong feeling that we should do something together. And that is that was the first stage in which we sort of trying to see where are the problems and how we make a report and we internationalize them and so on. But after some time, we felt, I mean, as a coalition, that just screaming how bad the things are, and, you know, it is not helping much, because those government, it's just a scratch to the government, and they don't know how to fix it anyway. So we, little by little, we change into a more solution-based, a more proactive-based, in which so many groups know how to work with poor people in a big way. Yeah? So we get together and we support the process in several countries. We raise funds and we pass the funding to many organization. We open new process in some new country like Cambodia, Vietnam, Laos, Nepal. No, these are some of the Mongolia. These are some of the new country in which we try to support, and support in such a way that people who have this idealism went there. It's among the Asia people, Asia to Asia, right? Because we have in some way similar culture and similar understanding about the sort of the system of different country in Asia. So we help each other. But our way of helping, we believe that poor people themselves should be an active actor. So we always go to the community and see how they would set up the saving group, how they would start the survey, and how the poor people would start off. Huh? And with the funding, sometimes we were able to support the upgrading, change the slum and link up with the government and see how the citywide change in some small city and so on could be possible. And little by little, it become a kind of a movement in which the Asia group themselves among so many countries work and learn from each other. Like I learn from Pakistan something, I learn from the Philippines something, you know, and the other country also learn from Thailand something, you know. It's sort of share and exchange, and whenever you find a new way to work, then you learn something together. And we found that it's quite efficient, the way in which we try to create a bigger room, bigger possibility, and intervene proactively, intervene the change in this country in such a way that it's a peer intervention, not project based, not a tick that, oh, we finished this project, you know.